Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the one Conquest of Champions press conference. My name is Mitch Chilson. I am so excited to be your MC for today's event. One Championship is the largest global sports media property in Asian history. We are the largest martial arts organization in the world. We are the home of martial arts, and we are returning yet again to Manila, Philippines. Every time we come to Manila, we have some exciting news for you. But first, let's take a look at a preview of what you can expect this November 23rd at the Mall of Asia Arena, one Conquest of Champions.
Everybody in this arena is on their feet.
The craziness, the awesomeness, the obliteration, a house on fire.
Every single time this man steps in the cage, it is purely fireworks.
It's good, North Irene, Amir Khan is back.
I think we can all agree that this is one of the most exciting cards we have ever had in Manila. In the main event for the one heavyweight world championship, the challenger from Italy, please welcome Mauro the Hammer Cerilli. He will be taking on your very own Filipino sports icon, the reigning, defending, heavyweight world champion, Brandon the Truth Vera! To find out more about this exciting bout, take a look at what these two have to say about their main event title shot.
He's been finishing a lot of his opponents first round, which means he's very explosive and very strong, which in turn makes him very dangerous.
Conosco il mio avversario, è una leggenda vera e propria, quindi sono onorato di combattere con lui. So che ha affrontato molti nomi noti.
I've been watching his videos every day, studying things on him. I've been working on becoming faster. I've been working on becoming more precise.
Il suo punto di forza, secondo me, è lo striking. C'è un modo in cui voglio finirlo. Voglio finirlo e basta. Come viene, viene. Già che parla di me, va bene. Sono contento che parla di me. Vediamo. Vediamo al match.
I'm not your champ when I'm fighting. I'm fighting for the belt, so I'm a challenger too. I'm just as hungry as that guy's coming across the cage from me. And I keep it that way, so I stay hungry.
Sono emozionatissimo. Voglio vincere la cintura di One per dimostrare a me stesso che non ho limiti.
I just want to fight. Let's see what happens. Don't blink.
That's gonna be a good one right there. So, let's get started, ladies and gentlemen. At the head table, we have a panel of some of the world's greatest martial artists, along with top representatives from One Championship and City of Dreams. I need you guys to make a lot of noise. I want them to hear us all over City of Dreams today. So please, help me welcome to the stage the CFO and chairman of Greater China of One Championship. Make some noise for Mr. Huang Fang Te! The CMO of Zalingo, show you love for Marita Abraham! The director of marketing operations of COD. Show you love for Mr. Nathan Sorensen! 1 athlete, Amir! Khan! 1 athlete, Eduard! Folayang! One world title challenger, Mauro! Cerilli! And the one heavyweight world champion, Brandon, the Truth, Vera! To kick off today's press conference, please put your hands together for the CFO of ONE Championship, Mr. Huang Feng Tae.
Thank you so much, Mitch, and thank you everyone for coming here. Mabuhay, Manila! Kamusta kayo? Okay, right? Are you guys pumped? Are you guys pumped? Because I am. You know why? You know why I'm pumped? I love coming to the Philippines. Here, we have some of the best martial artists, some of the best fans, some of the best partners in the whole world in one country. So first of all, I want to say thank you to the Philippines for your love and support. Thank you so much from the bottom of my heart. It means a lot to us to come here every single time, and it is a real privilege and joy to put on a show for you every single time. But at ONE Championship, we are just getting started. We want to do more and more and bring you the best of what our brand has to offer. Now, in the last couple of weeks, we've made a couple of big announcements. First, we made huge news all around the world when we welcomed some of the greatest martial artists in history to the ONE Championship family. Demetrius Johnson, Eddie Alvarez, Misha Tate. You're going to be seeing a lot of them next year, both in the cage and on screen, so watch out for that. We also announced the launch of our esports vertical. This is a potential multi-billion dollar business line for us. Like martial arts, esports is a big growing industry with a largely millennial audience. And we want to leverage our ability and scale to unleash world-class esports heroes and bring you world-class esports entertainment. ONE Esports will make us Asia's largest producer of sports content. And that will be the first time it's ever done by any sports media platform. Now today, I'm excited to announce yet another huge strategic initiative for the company, maybe even bigger than the last, which is also going to be a potential billion-dollar opportunity for us. At ONE Championship, we are going to launch an athleisure line. So sportswear, gear, apparel, lifestyle. We want to be able to compete against the Western giants like Nike and Adidas. This has never been attempted. This is unprecedented. Right? But I tell you what, right? We, unprecedented in that no global sports and lifestyle brand has ever come out of Asia. But I tell you what, we did it in sports media, we are doing it in esports, and now we're gonna do it in sports and lifestyle as well. Let's take a look at the video to show you what I mean. We'll be right back. think? What do you think? You like it? Now, as part of this initiative, we are also going to be launching an online store. And this will give consumers and fans like you guys direct access to One Championship merchandise all around the world. Anytime, every time, all the time. And, you know, this will include stuff like workout and athletic gear, streetwear, and limited edition items that were previously only available at live events. So now you can go one click and you can dress like your favorite One Championship athlete or your favorite One Championship CFO. That's just one. I would like to thank our partners for this launch, Zulingo. This is Southeast Asia's largest lifestyle, fashion, and beauty platform. Their CMO is here with us today. Thank you so much for your partnership and support, and I look forward to working with you in the years ahead. Please join me in thanking Zulingo. Marita is her CMO. Now, one more thing I want to announce also is a new brand partnership with one of the Philippines' best-known brands. I'm very excited to tell everyone that we will be partnering with Red Horse Beer. So this is one of the most popular beers in the Philippines. It's actually one of my personal favorites, to be honest. They actually tell me it's the number one beer in the Philippines. Well, ito ang tama. And last but not least, any thank you message would not be complete without a thank you to the City of Dreams, our beautiful home when we come to Manila. Thank you so much for making the One Championship family so welcome. Thank you for your hospitality, your venues, your amenities are such a treat for all our staff and our athletes. So thank you. So as you guys know, this week's event, Conquest of Champions, is our last show in Manila this year. And mark my words, this will be the biggest martial arts event this year in the Philippines. The card is stacked with both Filipino and international superstars. You guys saw the video, main event. Brandon Vera, the reigning one world heavyweight champion, defending his belt against Italy's Mauro Cerilli. Brandon is one of the greatest heavyweights the world has ever seen. He is a giant in the sport of mixed martial arts and has shared the cage with some of the biggest names in mixed martial arts history. And today he lives here in the Philippines, helping to guide Filipino martial arts to the next level. He is undefeated in the one cage and has been One Championship's only heavyweight world champion. But as many of you know, he has been away from the cage for almost 2 years now. So many fans and members of the public have been asking us, does Brandon Vera still have it? Does Brandon Vera still have it? Well, at One Championship, we have full faith in him. But it is a question many of you have asked us. I will let him answer this question later. But what I can tell you is Mauro over here is the toughest challenge Brandon has faced yet. Mauro is a former Cage Warriors heavyweight champion. He is a knockout specialist. He has crossed the Asian and European continents to come here to try to take the belt from Brandon. He is unbeaten as a heavyweight. And in the last 2 years that Brandon was away, Mauro has been chalking up wins. He has won 5 consecutive fights, 4 of which were by way of TKO or knockout. That's huge. And I do know this, Mauro has a huge overhand right, which I don't care how good you are, will be trouble for any athlete if landed right. So Brandon has his work cut out for him. It is going to be a clash of two great titans, a clash you guys do not want to miss this Friday. The co-main event is going to be a spectacle as well. The Philippines' biggest martial arts hero, the face of Philippines martial arts, Eduard Folayang, is back here. Back here to try to make history as the first two-time lightweight world champion in One Championship history. And he will face Singaporean Mr. KO himself, Mr. Amir Khan. Eduard, as you know, comes from Baguio City, where he trains with his brothers in the renowned Team Lakai. Team Lakai is one of the top martial arts gyms in the world. And today, there are three world champions in one championship from this gym. Eduard will try to make that number four this Friday. But for Eduard, there is a lot more to this fight than just becoming a world champion again. For him, this is a culmination of a long journey back here to win back the very same belt that he lost in front of his hometown crowd 1 year ago. It is a chance at redemption. It is a chance, just like for Brandon, to show the world that this belt is his and he's here to stay. But as we all know, Amir is no slouch, okay? Amir is no slouch. He has the most knockouts in one championship history, and the stakes are really high for Amir as well. He has a chance to become the first homegrown Singaporean world champion in history. You can be sure the entire country of Singapore, I know it's a bit smaller than the Philippines, but the whole country will be watching Amir as he takes on Eduard. So make no mistake, I think Amir is basically public enemy number one this Friday as he looks to stop Eduard Folayang from being the one world lightweight champion one more time. We shall see. So once again, friends, I'd just like to say, and I know I've said this already, but I truly mean it, it's always great to be back in the Philippines and Manila. The Philippines is one country that truly and deeply appreciates martial arts. And this is why we keep coming back show after show after show. But let us never forget that martial arts and one championship at its core is not about the fights. At its core, we are about unleashing heroes that ignite the world with hope, strength, dreams, and inspiration. Heroes that embody the age-old Asian values of integrity, humility, honor, respect, courage, discipline, and compassion. I myself have a black belt in Taekwondo, and I'm sure many of you here like me who spent a good part of their lives practicing martial arts knows what I mean when I say that martial arts is truly much more than just about fighting. So Manila, on Friday, let us make history one more time. Let us celebrate these truly remarkable heroes as they put on the best show on earth for you. Thank you, and see you at the Mall of Asia Arena.
Thank you very much, Mr. Hua Fong Te. Black belt in Taekwondo? Yeah, I like that. I like that. Okay, we are truly excited to announce that One Championship is embarking on a partnership with Zalingo to bring our unique brand of clothing to the world and to launch an online store to fans. So, up next to the podium, please show your love, guys. Show her some Filipino love to the CMO of Zalingo, Miss Marita Abraham!
Hello. Sorry, just checking. So thanks so much for that beautiful introduction. So I'm Marita, I'm Chief Marketing Officer at Zalingo, and I'm here to tell you a little bit more about who we are and celebrate this new partnership that we have with One. So a little bit about Zalingo. What we do is we're an e-commerce platform focusing on beauty, fashion, beauty, and lifestyle. And we are essentially building a tech platform that sits across the fashion supply chain. We do business across 6 countries in Southeast Asia, and we're actually going to come to the Philippines very soon. We have a B2C platform called Zalingo.com. This is a fashion marketplace. So the idea is that anybody who loves fashion can come onto Zalingo and find whatever they love. We also have a B2B platform, which is through which is the business through which we're working with One. And here, what we do is we help merchants and entrepreneurs that do business in fashion to scale and empower them to compete in the digital economy. So I feel like this relationship is sort of a match made in heaven. Our values and our culture is very strongly aligned with one's. One has, built these massive, beautiful experiences for its fans. At the same time, one is also empowering its athletes to really compete on the global platform for sport. Similarly, Zilingo is also committed to creating beautiful experiences for fashion shoppers globally. And at the same time, we're looking to empower our merchants and build an ecosystem that can help fashion, beauty, and lifestyle merchants grow and compete with big players in the market. So I do feel like this is really a fantastic relationship, and we're super excited to get this started. Our personal relationship with One and with Chhatri go way back. We've known this brand and this company since we were really a tiny, tiny startup. So it's very fulfilling to now finally partner with One to launch this athleisure line. So a little bit more about the line itself. We've been working closely with One to create this line literally from scratch. So everything from design to manufacturing to finally shipping this to you guys. All of the work under the hood is a partnership between us. And we're really excited to sort of be under the hood while this global sports brand that is One Championship now embarks on a new journey, something that we are really kicked to see how this happens, right? I really believe that athleisure is no longer a niche in fashion. It is now a mega culture. It's celebrated by the world's biggest sportsmen and the biggest celebrities. It's also celebrated on the streets. And we do see that this is going to be now the next big adventure, the next big business move for the brand, and we're looking forward to being a close partner as well. So I think that's it from me. But before I end, I do want to say all the best to the fighters. Watching you guys in action is truly inspiring, truly phenomenal, and I've been to a lot of the matches, and I'm always enthralled. So this is for you guys, and this is for, at the end, I think this partnership is also to celebrate your work and what you do in the ring. So all the best. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Marita. Next, please help me welcome the Director of Operations at COD. Please make some love for Nathan Sorensen!
All right, good afternoon. On behalf of our Senior Vice President and our COO, Mr. Kevin Benning, and over 5,000 team members here, I would like to welcome all of you to City of Dreams, Manila. We take great pride in continuing our partnership with One Championship and to bring world-class sports and entertainment to Filipino fans across the country. We support One's endeavor to highlight the discipline, code of honor, and sportsmanship of mixed martial arts. And for the fourth time this year, we are privileged to support Conquest of Champions, November 23rd at SM Mall of Asia Arena. City of Dreams has also been the residence of One Athletes offering world-class accommodations. Nuwa Hotel, which has recently achieved a Forbes five-star rating, Nobu Hotel, as well as Hyatt Hotel. I'd also like to acknowledge some of our signature restaurants, Tasting Room, Crystal Dragon, as well as Nobu. One Athletes can expect nothing but the best here at City of Dreams. In closing, I'd like to share everyone's excitement and anticipation for this weekend's event, Friday. It'll be explosive. I wish all the fighters the best of luck. And thank you. Have a great afternoon.
Thank you very much, Mr. Sorensen. Our first athlete to the podium comes all the way from Singapore. And this Friday night has a chance to become the One Lightweight World Champion. Please help me welcome to the podium and show some love for Amir Khan!
afternoon, everyone. Hope everyone is having a good time today. I'm so excited to be fighting Manila for the second time, actually. I fought here 4 years ago, and this time fighting for the vacant one lightweight world title. I'm going to be competing against Eduard, your hometown hero. I have the utmost respect for Folayang. He's a tough warrior in and out the cage. He was the former champ and high caliber martial artist. But I'm 100% confident that I'll get the victory this Friday. To be honest, if you ask me 4 years ago if I have to face Eduard, I would think he's crazy. I mean, I wouldn't stand a chance 4 years ago. But like how Singapore is the fastest developing country in the world, so goes with their athletes and their people too. So, I think that's it for today. I'm sorry.
Thank you very much, Amir. Up next is a man who needs absolutely no introduction. A Filipino martial arts superstar and the former one lightweight world champion. Please give it up for Eduard the Landslide Folayang!
Magandang hapon sa lahat ng andito sa City of Dreams. Pinatataban nyo naman ang puso ko. Well, to begin, I believe that this is another story to be unfolded. Last year I was in the same place, but things didn't go on the expectations that I have. I lost the belt, but I worked my ass out. So now there is another story to be para may abangan tayo. And andito ako ngayon dahil alam ko pinaghirapan ko, bumangon ako doon sa pagkatalo natin. And of course, that's what martial arts is. We're just not here, or I'm not just here to be fighting for the belt, but I want to prove that, you know, even if you fall, there is always 100 chance for us to come back and show to the world that a single defeat cannot define us, but it will unleash the best of us. Mabuhay at magandang hapon sa ating lahat.
That's gonna be a good one, ladies and gentlemen. But now, we gotta move on to the main event. So first up to the podium, please give a big, warm Filipino welcome to the Cage Warriors heavyweight champion. And now, one world title challenger from Italy, Mauro the Hammer. Cerilli!
Ciao Manila! Ciao! Ciao a tutti! Allora, innanzitutto volevo ringraziare la One per questa opportunità Volevo ringraziare il presidente per questa opportunità. E una cosa che ci tengo a dire, mi sono sentito come a casa, sono stato accolto benissimo in questa famiglia, la famiglia di Juan. Quindi sono contentissimo di poter far parte di questa famiglia. Diciamo che Juan rispecchia molto il mio modo di vivere le mixed martial arts. Quindi sono mixed martial arts fatte di rispetto, sacrificio e professionalità.
Bravo, bravo. Hello. Yeah. Hello everybody. Thank you for the opportunity. Thank you Philippine for the way you welcome me. Thank you to the One family for the way you welcome me. I want to thank the president. I want to thank all the Filipinos that make me feel home already. And I'm very happy to be here, especially because the way one approach mixed martial arts really reflects my character, the way I am. And I couldn't be happier to be here.
Se guardo indietro di pochi anni non avrei mai pensato di arrivare a questo, di essere su un palco davanti a centinaia di giornalisti e di far parte di questa big promotion, tantomeno di poter affrontare una leggenda come Brandon.
If I look back few years ago, I would never imagine that I could have the chance to be here in front of all these media. To have this huge opportunity, to have the chance to face a legend as Brandon Vera. So I'm pretty blessed.
Cercherò di non deludervi, anche se so che è il vostro campione, è il vostro preferito, quindi so che sarete tutti con lui. Io farò del mio meglio e spero che come andrà il match, mi rispetterete comunque. Grazie ancora, grazie a tutti.
Even though I know obviously you cheer for him, Brandon is from here, is the local guy. I'm gonna do my best to honor this chance, and I hope that no matter how the fight goes, I will gain the respect of ONE FC and especially of the Filipino people. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Mauro. The next athlete is everyone's favorite martial arts superstar. Everyone's favorite actor. But most importantly, he's the reigning, defending, ONE heavyweight world champion. Show your love to Brandon, the truth, Vera!
Kumusta ka, babayan? Pasensya ha, kinakabahan ako. Pinapawis ako sa loob ng suit na to. Tagal na ako dito. Nawala dito. Broke. Tagless to ha. Tagless to. Broken down in its most simplest form. Ang daming ko papasalamat sa inyong lahat. Daming kong papasalamat sa Pilipinas at daming kong papasalamat dito sa bansa. Before I moved to the Philippines, being a champion was just a cool thought, cool idea, something that I worked towards, something that I wanted, something that I figured would be something attainable if I didn't really have to work that hard at it. And then realize I didn't understand all of this until I moved to the Philippines. Kasalanan nyo. I used to only work out two times, three times a week. I promise. Kita mong katawan ko, mataba pa ako noon. I was never in shape like I should have been. I didn't train unless I had a camp, unless I had a contract. Dito, sa mga mukha nyo, on your smiles, when you say hello to me every day, naisip ko, pasensya ha, naisip ko, puta. I can't. Taka. Pasensya sa mura. But yung iniisip ko talaga, man, I owe. Mandami pang utang ako sa inyo. Kaso sa ngiti lang. I owe you more than a smile. I owe you more than me just being here. I owe you more. So yung nangyari dito, I came here, we started filming a movie. Pinikula dito and showbiz here is hard. Grabe, 18-hour days, 14-hour days is real. On locations, hindi ka na uwi. Ganyan talaga. But showing up here, moving to the Philippines, dealing with traffic, dealing with location sets, dealing with entertainment world, dealing with contracts, dealing with the grind. Now, naiintindihan ko talaga. I work out every damn day. Every single day. I'm training twice a day. Once a day. From a 48-hour shoot, diretso muna ako sa gym, haba ako muuwi matulog. And then I go back to the set again. So am I ready? After 2 years of being away from the center of that ring? Hell yes. Hell yes. Alam mo, and to come back is already scary. And, you know, I never went anywhere. To call it a comeback is kind of weird. But for me to be back in after such a long pause doing the entertainment world, and then for them to find this monster, Mauro, grab it, Brandon. Hey, okay, welcome back. Itong kalaban mo. He beat his last five guys. The last four guys, he knocked out. Okay, game ka? Oh, sige, subukan natin. So basta, come Friday night. Show up, show out. Enjoy the evening. And I want to thank all of my martial artists. Mauro, marami salamat. Thank you very much. Grazie. Eduard. Amir, I'm so excited to watch your guys' this fight too. Salamat sa inyong suporta. Wala na akong masabi. Bye.
Thank you so much, champ. I'm sure by now you guys have a lot of questions. So, we're gonna get started next with the media Q&A. So, all you gotta do is raise your hand, state your name and publication, and we will bring the microphone to you. Mr. Huafeng, please. Back to the podium. First question.
For Mr. Wang Fante, after the groundbreaking announcement of the store, anything else that we should expect the next coming days?
Well, there's always things to look forward to with us, right? We're a fast-growing company. We keep trying to do new things to innovate and bring more products and offerings for our fans. And our fan base, as you know, is growing like crazy. Look, I think there will be more things coming up. I can tell you that, you know, we talked a little bit about some of the big time global martial arts icons joining us, right? DJ, Eddie, and Misha. I expect to see potentially more people coming on board, many people that, you know, of that similar status. But in terms of the core things that we're launching, I think, you know, at this point, the rest of the stuff at this point is confidential. So yeah, but there will be more things coming.
Thank you.
Always will be with us. So
thank you very much.
Oh, okay. Hello, good afternoon. I'm Santino Nasan from ABS-CBN Sports. For this card, for this final card in 2018 in Manila, you have arguably two of the biggest Filipino mixed martial arts heroes in Eduard Folayang and Brandon Vera competing on the same card, both competing for world championships. Would you say that this is the biggest one championship card that Manila has ever seen? Thank you.
That's a very good question. You know, we always have good cards, right, when we come to Manila. But I tell you what, you're right to say that these are two of the greatest Filipino martial artists ever. One is a world champion, the other is a former world champion. Both of them are two of the biggest faces here, right, for Philippine martial arts. I mean, I will say this, we've never had an event that sees both of them competing for world titles, right? One, of course, is a defense, but both competing for world titles at the same time. So from that perspective, yes, this would be the biggest card for one championship in Manila ever.
Good afternoon. Brian Yalong from the Manila Bulletin. My question is addressed to Ms. Marita Abraham. From an e-commerce point of view, how revolutionary is this partnership with One Championship?
Thanks for the question. So I think revolutionary is the fact that we've done this in a crazy short span of time. Revolutionary is the fact that under the hood, what this athleisure line means is that now fans globally in 150 countries across the world can shop for a broad range of athletic wear. And I think what is going to be revolutionary is, again, once again, Asia's biggest sports property, One Championship, leading the way for sports partnerships and the mix of sports and fashion, and sort of setting the path for other sports brands to follow. So I do think that this is something very new and very innovative, always as true to one's culture and true to what one stands for, paving the way forward for the next generation of sports brands. So I think this is actually going to be super cool.
Dennis Gisgonya from ABS-CBN. I'd like to pose this question to Mr. Sarinson. I'd like to ask how much did the City of Dreams benefited from its partnership with One Championship?
Thank you. It's been a partnership that I think that has been mutually successful for both One Championship and City of Dreams, and looking forward to the future. We're looking to continue this partnership, and hopefully it can be something great to look forward to for all the fight fans in the Philippines and for both One and City of Dreams.
Hi, good afternoon. I'm JMC Asset from GMA News. The question is for both Brandon Vera and Mauro. They say in the world of combat sports, there are two possible outcomes when you're coming from a long layoff. First is that, coming from a long rest, your body's fresh, it actually helps you. Or second, you could come back inside that ring or inside that cage rusty. So the question is for Mauro, do you think Brandon would be coming back as a rusty fighter, or do you think he's a much fresher athlete? Same goes for Brandon.
Pensi che Brandon tornerà dopo due anni d'assenza più riposato, più mi senti? Tornerà più fresco, più riposato dopo due anni d'assenza, o ci avrà la ruggine? Quindi l'assenza per te è un vantaggio o uno svantaggio?
Secondo me si sarà allenato molto bene,
quindi non credo che io possa avere un vantaggio dalla sua assenza. A prescindere dal film che ha fatto, ha detto comunque che si è allenato, non trascura lo sport, perché ogni fighter vive per questo sport, quindi è difficile farne a meno, quindi sono sicuro che sarà al 100%.
Every fighter lives for the sport, so even though Brandon kind of left the sport for 2 years for the movie, I'm sure that he's going to be 100%, and I'm sure that he did everything possible to be ready for the fight.
Hello? Hindi naman talaga nagkakalawang tao eh. Hindi naman ako metal. Pasensya ha. Hindi. Kinakaba. Kalawang wala. Kung meron, sigurado pag natamaan ako ni Cerilli, mawawala rin yun. Promise. So, basta, ready na talaga. Ready na. Sobra. Thank you.
Good afternoon, Paolo Gonzalez, Fight Sport Manila. For Mr. Wafongte, as we all know, the lightweight division is the most stacked division in ONE Championship. And even before Eduard versus Amir was made, there were other fights that could have been possibly for the lightweight title. I would just want to know your thoughts on why you decided Eduard and Amir Khan to be the one to take for the vacant championship.
You're right. The lightweight division is highly competitive. And as you know, Eddie, the underground king Alvarez, has just joined us. And that's going to obviously increase the competition. Look, I think these two, you know, these two fighters' performances over the past, you know, months and years has speaks for himself, right? Amir has, as I mentioned, you know, the most number of knockouts in ONE Championship history. He's a young star. He has an aggressive fighting style. And, you know, this is, you know, for us, it was a pretty, you know, obvious choice, just given his performance, especially in the recent year. Eduard, once again, you know, one of the greatest martial arts in the Philippines, and today, you know, he is arguably the face of Philippines of mixed martial arts. He's had a tough road back here, right? A tough road back here, but I think he's earned his way. He has earned his way back into title contention. His last two fights were against two, you know, he had victories against two undefeated Russians. So look, he has earned his stripes, he's earned his way back here. Amir, with his track record, you know, for us, this was an obvious one to do, but also an obvious one to do in Manila. You know, like I said, this will be the biggest card in Manila history. You know, am I right? Two of the biggest hometown heroes in Manila's martial arts history will be competing for world titles at the same time. So for us, it was an obvious choice.
Question for Eduard Folayang. Eduard, do you think that a potential win on Friday will be the sweetest victory in your career, especially if you're going to look at, you had a wonderful camp, you trained at Jackson Wink, you wrapped it off at Team Lakai, it's your birthday on Thursday. And it only took you a year to get back into the title picture. Do you think that this victory will be the sweetest?
Yeah, I want to claim that, you know. Of course, it's not only about that, but my tough loss last year was, you know, it's very hard to get through, but you know, I really worked hard, and now the opportunity was here, present again, and I don't want to miss that gift You know, I don't want to miss that gift. I want to get it as much as possible. That's why, you know, I really do my part so that I can be able to be 100% ready for this fight on Friday.
Follow-up question. Win or lose, are you ready to suit up for the lightweight Grand Prix next year?
I don't want to hear that loss, but yes, I'm into it.
Question for Amir Khan. Amir, we've seen how much you've grown as a martial artist from the very beginning of your first time in the one cage. Now you have the most finishes in the history of the promotion. And you have your first chance at the world title. What does it mean to you to become a world champion?
Becoming a world champion means everything to me. I mean, I'm sure me and I feel Edward feel the same way. We'll put our life on the line for it. We'll give it our all. This is what I've been working hard for the past years. And I feel I have grown so much in one championship. And now I'm truly ready. And I'm 100% confident I'll get the belt on Friday.
Hi, Kathy. This is for Brandon Vera. So, back in 2015, when you fought, you were very confident. I did not see any hesitations or nervousness. You knocked out your opponent in 27 seconds flat. So everyone who blinked didn't get to see that. They just saw your opponent lie down. And when you were asked why you ended the fight so early, you said that since you were fighting in your hometown, you cannot afford to lose, that you would rather kill yourself rather than lose. Do you still hold the same passion and the same statement for the fight this Friday, seeing that you seem more nervous and hesitant in this fight? Is it because you've been gone for 2 years?
I've been gone, so dun galing yung kaba. But yung sinabi ko noon sa iyo, totoo pa ngayon. I would much rather die than lose in front of the Philippines. There's no way. Hindi ko kaya. Hindi ko kaya yun. Hindi ko kaya yun. I'm just as committed. I'm giving even more. I just want it more now. So, yes, ma'am. Tama. Opo.
Hi, I'm Carl from FHM Philippines. This is for Mauro. Sir, having come from Cage Warriors, having faced the best in the European circuit, how does this stack up right now? How do you feel stepping onto the biggest stage in Asia?
Venendo da Cage Warrior, avendo sconfitto i migliori atleti europei, come ti senti adesso in questo su questo palcoscenico enorme?
Sono carico e Questa chance mi ha motivato ancora di più, quindi voglio mettermi a confronto con un atleta di livello mondiale, quale Brandon, quindi sono contentissimo e farò del mio meglio per vincere.
I'm very pumped, I'm very excited and I think that now is the moment for me to challenge a high level worldwide competitor like Brandon, so I couldn't be happier than be here.
Hello. For Amir Khan, I'm Russell from Manila Times. You have the opportunity to become the first homegrown Singaporean world champion. How differently you have prepared for this bout against Eduard?
I mean, for every fight, the next fight is always the toughest fight of my life. So I always train similar to every fight, but the only thing changes is our game plan. Me and my head coach, we got a solid game plan for this fight. And definitely it's a good opportunity for one championship for me to become the first homegrown world champion from Singapore. So of course I'm going to give it all for this fight. Even though I know the odds may stack against me, I'm fighting in his home crowd in Philippines, but I won't let it play it to affect my performance. I hope everyone will enjoy my performance that night.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have time for one final question.
Leon Jennings from Asian Persuasion MMA. Question for Edward. How inspired were you with Kevin's performance recently?
I'm so inspired. Kevin is a hard worker. He's very fast, and he really worked hard for that fight against Bibiano, and you have seen his performance. He was able to deliver his game plan right, and it's such a big inspiration for me, and I will be using it for this upcoming fight this Friday.
All righty, thank you for all of your questions. I would now like to invite all of the media and photographers into the pit as we get ready for our face-off photo opportunity. Ladies and gentlemen, you do not want to miss Friday night, the 23rd of November. The stars have come out. Please welcome the one, the former one featherweight world champion, Honorio Banario. Ladies and gentlemen, we also have one of the most decorated kickboxers in the world in the crowd right now. Please make some noise for the Dr. Giorgio Petrosian. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we're gonna get started with our, before we get started with our photo face-off opportunity, I would like to invite the CMO of Zalingo, Miss Marita Abraham, up on stage to join Hua Feng Te. Photographers, please lower your cameras just a bit. We got guys in the back that need to make sure they get their shots. So if you just slow down just a little bit, thank you very much. Thank you very much, Marita. Up next, please help me welcome the Director of Marketing Operations of COD, Mr. Nathan Sorensen. Mr. Sorensen. All right, ladies and gentlemen, moving on to the event night athletes. Facing off first in the One Super Series kickboxing contest, please welcome from Japan, Hiroaki Suzuki. And his opponent from Lithuania, Deividas, Danyla. Much, gentlemen. Up next, please welcome from Arizona, USA, show your love to James Nakashima. and his opponent from Russia, Raimond Magomedaliev! Gentlemen, that's gonna be a great one. Up next, in the one Super Series Muay Thai bout, representing Russia, making a quick turnaround, show your love for Alaverdi, Ramazanov, and his opponent from Thailand, Saemapetch. Fairtex! Thank you, gentlemen. Ladies and gentlemen, in the co-main event, facing off now is the rising star from Singapore. Please welcome Amir Khan and his opponent, your hometown hero from the Philippines. Give it up for Eduard, the landslide, Folayang! Gentlemen, the lightweight title will be decided Friday night. And now, the match you've all been waiting for, the one heavyweight world championship. Please welcome the title challenger from Italy, Mauro the Hammer, Cerilli. And without further ado, your reigning, defending, one heavyweight world champion, Brandon the Truth Vera! Guys, I got photographers in the back that need their shot. If you could lower your cameras just a bit. We'll be right back. Oh, that's going to be a good one, ladies and gentlemen. You do not want to miss November 23rd at the Mall of Asia Arena. Thank you to all the media, the guests, and our partners. Without you, this event would not be possible. We got lunch and snacks and refreshments over in the next room. And we will see you November 23rd for one Conquest of Champions! Thank you very much!